And here is the New Haven triple plate, all done. And it's probably gonna chime soon. Yes, here it is. Only you experienced clockmakers have ever come across these. The New Haven Clock Company triple plate movement with Westminster chime. Next thing we need to do is to figure out the home position of the chiming unit. The chiming unit is activated by the minute arbor. These four pins on the bottom of the minute arbor, look how short they are. And you see one is spaced further away than the other three towards the, this is the 12. Okay, let's reactivate it again. Falls into the next one. It pushes that sub plate behind it with a spring out of the way, and then it catches. Let's do it again. As soon as I lift up this lever, that sub plate with the spring is going to jump. Watch this. See the way, and now it no longer can fall in there. That sub plate closed up the slot. What we want to do is to get it into the 15-minute mark. Oh, that subplate's all gummed up too. This looks like it might be the 45-minute mark. Watch how that it hits that plate now. It goes down into the thing, and then it pushes that plate out of the way and drops down further, and it locks in just like you see it. When it jumps out of and goes into warning. Okay, so now we're in the home position of the strike. The gathering pallet is even, and it allows the rack in order to pass by all the pins on the gathering pallet. You know that this is the gathering pallet, don't you? This little disc with three pins on it. Find a piece of brass that was thin enough, so I decided to check how loose this cam is on here. And I'm glad I did, because I can twist it. And off she comes.
I have a little piece of metal, a part stand that I've made with holes in it that fits right into my ultrasonic cleaner. And it keeps the relationship of all the parts the same. So you don't have to remember where all the parts go. You just look at their arrangement inside this little standoff. And whenever you do anything to the parts, whether it be cleaning, or rinsing, or going to the polish bench to polish all the components, and then going back to the assembly bench, you don't need to keep these things in memory. You can just keep them in order. It's so much easier. I came up with an interesting problem. Like everything else to do with this movement, nothing is easy. Every other manufacturer in the world has got the square arbor going into the spring from the open cap. New Haven decided to have it opposite, like that.
Okay, we're back from the cleaning and polishing of all the pivots. I didn't find any pivots in bad condition. And the first thing I would like to do is check out all of the bushings, which ones on the, between the sub plate and the front plate. So I put the four wheels in there for the time assembly. And okay, what I did, I hooked up my Time Tracks audio amplifier to it just so I could hear the shake. We got shake there. Got shake there. I don't think we have any shake there. Now, a special little problem that you'll come across with these triple plates is that lubrication-wise, you got to take it in steps. Right now, I'm just going to be lubing the pivots that are coming through, but how do you lube the pivots after you put the from the sub plate to the back plate in? Well, you really can't. So what we need to do, and that would explain why these bushings get so bad. So I'm just going to go ahead and lube each one of the ones that are on the sub plate here. Okay, we're now in the beginning stages of putting it back together. And of course the gears are all in there, but as far as the levers go, they're a strange bird in themselves. So this arbor here that had nothing connected to it, well, now's the time to connect up this lever right here, which runs the closest to the front plate. Kind of difficult to put it on something because of all these levers are in the way. It doesn't really like to sit there nice and low. Well, we're proceeding on putting everything together. It's the next day, and so I went ahead and I popped in the mainsprings, and each one of the mainspring arbors, the barrels and the caps and the springs, all are unique to its function, so make sure you don't mix up these guys. That's why I like to put a little scratch on it, like S and C for chime and T for time. Oh, before we do that, we need to stake on the gathering pallet. To do that, you hold the movement from behind with some kind of a cardboard piece here. You put a stake over that there. This is a stake, just a metal rod where you can hit it with a hammer on one side and it's got a hole on the other. And you put it on top of the gathering pallet so when you hit it, it does not hit the arbor itself. It just slides the gathering pallet on. Set up the striking and the chiming. Just make sure that after the chiming finishes, that there is no hammers that are being pulled like this. Right now it's about to stop right now, and you'll see all the hammers come to a stop right there and none of them being lifted. And then when you lift again, and here is the New Haven triple plate, all done. And it's probably gonna chime soon. And another clock is brought back to life.